fanga.
At first, Umm Halima tried to fight off her abductor.
When they announced their plans to marry us, we rejected it.
Then she realized she had no choice.
We watched how they slaughtered so many of the women and men, so we got frightened.
But she told us from the very first day of her capture by the Nigerian terror group Boko Haram, she was planning her escape. Eventually, she succeeded, when the husband she never wanted was off fighting. Today, she's back in her own home and 7 months pregnant. She's asked to conceal her identity and refer to her by Umm Halima, not her real name. The fear is still with her. This time, though, it's the men in her own community.
People in this village are rejecting me because of the pregnancy. Some will be happy to have me dead. Many people are even saying that I should go for an abortion. Only my mom wants me to keep the pregnancy.
But Umm Halima's mother is one of the few. There are no exact figures, but aid agencies and government officials have told CNN that an alarming percentage of the girls rescued from Boko Haram have returned pregnant. And now, despite their ordeal, they are outcasts. Under the weight of the stigma, some of them are now choosing to risk their lives with risky abortions rather than give birth to their abductors' babies. Umm Halima's father was killed by Boko Haram, and when her mother first heard her daughter had been abducted, she feared the worst.
Anybody captured by Boko Haram is presumed dead. They abducted my stepdaughter and my daughter. They took a total of 7 girls from this house.
She refuses to contemplate losing her daughter again.
We heard a girl died after she attempted an abortion, losing both the mother and the baby. The girl was the only child to her mother, so that scared us. If God wishes, she will give birth safely. Life is in the hands of God alone.
A CNN team spoke to the men Umm Halima accuses of threatening her. Part of a local vigilante group, they denied the threats.
I'm not aware of any woman in this village who is impregnated by them. If any woman is found to be pregnant, in our tradition, the pregnancy is considered haram, unlawful. That's why we cannot accept them wholeheartedly, because they can be like baby snakes.
It's not a denial, Umm Halima says she finds reassuring, but she tells us, whatever they say, having survived abduction and escape, she knows that she's strong enough to see this through. Nemal Bahir, CNN in Northern Nigeria.